Capricorn, welcome back. Welcome to your February reading, the Lovers Month. Welcome, welcome, guys. Capricorn, these are general, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, or Jupiter. These are not for every Capricorn. Obviously, not all of you will resonate here, as they are not personal. Alright, so if it doesn't resonate, then it's not your story. You know how that goes, yada, 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 right? Alright, guys, thank you so much for being here. Thank you for your likes, your shares, your subscriptions, all your wonderful, beautiful comments. And to those who have donated to the channel, thank you so much. Capricorn, you're here, so please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, share, 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 and hit that notification bell for those of you who would like to know when your monthly readings pop up. And let's get to it. Let's do it. We're going to start with Amira's Love Oracle, and let's see what we got going on for you for the month of February. Alright, Spirit. Let's get a message for my collective Capricorns out there. Let's see. These are coming out a little choppy. Chop chop is what I'm hearing. Something about, what is that? Chuck Wood? Okay. Number three is significant here. Woodchuck, chuck. Maybe woodpeckers are significant for somebody here. Or you're chopping some wood. I don't know, depending on where you live there. All right, let's see what we got here, Capricorn. Short-term connection. So this is you, and you know how I read, this is you or your person. Okay, if you're watching for a Capricorn, or, you know, somebody with Capricorn in their chart, or even if you're watching your sun sign, but you find that typically it resonates with your person, that could be it as well. Okay, so take it how it resonates. It'll be different for all of you. So we have a short-term connection. We have a brunette female here. She has green eyes. Some of you could have green eyes. Doesn't have to be. Let's see. Oh, we have dating with spiritual growth. And we have an ice queen behind that with some sort of union. So I feel like one of these was a short term. I'm guessing it's the ice queen here because we're dating, or we want to date some type of brunette here. Okay, or the brunette would like to date someone. And it's all about spiritual growth. So somebody could have found themselves in a little short-term lesson here. You know, here for a season and a reason, not a lifetime. It's not a lifetime sentence. Okay? Soul ties are not supposed to be confused with long-term partners. If that was it, it could have just been a karmic situation. So let's see here. Let's see. Let's get into the romance angels. See what else is going on here. What's going on, Capris? My Capris. Okay, we have attraction. You attract romantic love by enjoying this moment fully. I definitely feel some single energy out there, but somebody has someone in mind here. So either you, Capricorn, has someone in mind, or you both have each other in mind here. But somebody is courting somebody here. Okay? That's what I'm saying. Yeah, keep an open mind. Your soulmate. There you go. You have a soulmate here. Your soulmate may differ from your usual type and expectations. So somebody wants to get to know you better. And they're keeping an open mind. Open to trying something new. Because there's a soul bond here. There's a magnetic pull this person's feeling here. And worth waiting for. So somebody definitely just went through a breakup here. So divine timing is at work in your love life. And we already saw the spiritual growth. So this could be one of those twin flame journeys for a lot of you. Or you're meeting a good high-level soulmate that also... You learn from each other and you gain even more spiritual growth. So that's good. Not quite like a karmic soul tie. Those are hell on earth. But I feel it's either a twin flame or a high level soulmate here. Someone you can actually vibe with on a good vibration. Let's see what else we got. Yeah, make the effort. Great love is worth taking the steps you're guided to take. And somebody here has children. Your love life is being affected by children. There could be some distance here between you guys. And it says you deserve love. You are lovable. So definitely you deserve this kind of love. It is worth waiting for. Okay, so that's good. So let's see. Oh. Yeah. So I see somebody thought they had found the one before. With this could be the one. You've already met the romantic partner you seek, but you see we're freeing ourselves. It was meant to be short term. It was meant to be a lesson. So somebody could have thought, you know, the one they were with was the one, and there was definitely control issues here. We did see that Ice Queen, so allow the situation to unfold naturally. Yeah. Yeah, I feel like it even, there was talk of getting together, and there was talk of engagement and marriage here, because there was a lot of passion here. But they had a heart-to-heart conversation. Yeah, because it was unrequited, and there was too many red flags, okay, after getting to know each other. You know, that's what happens when that honeymoon phase fades and you start to really hone in on who you're with. Some things just don't start to add up, and that's what happened here. So they had a heart-to-heart conversation, honestly discuss your feelings with each other, with unrequited. So somebody said, you know what, I think it's time to let this go, release your ex, because I don't feel the same way anymore that I did in the beginning or before. You know, pay attention to the red flags, control issues, you know, freeing yourself, you know, after getting to know each other. That's what I see here. So now there's new love. And you guys are going to enjoy that beautiful, you know, honeymoon phase together. Now, there could be a little separation between you two after that. Because I do feel there's a distance here. But you'll be flirting with one another somehow, some way. And this person will express it after getting to know you, I feel, for some time. Because this person has a little trouble with trusting, okay? Especially if they went through some things here. Or you, Capricorn. But they will give this a chance. Okay? So let me not get too ahead of the game here. So this is somebody you're going to have to tread with, I don't want to say caution, just lightly. Don't overwhelm them with, you know, oh my God, marriage and kids and let's be together forever. Because this person just went through looks like a bumpy breakup with someone that was quite controlling, okay? And they really thought that that was going to be the one. And it clearly was not. It's short term. And that could have been you, Capricorn, that you went through that. If you're not watching for your person that's in that situation, you could have went through that. So new love is coming. New love. Let's get into that. I'm going to use the Fantasy Erotic Tarot. Let's see what's happening here. Two more. So maybe he told somebody to go chop wood. Yeah. Okay, one more. Ooh, Ten of Swords, Ten of Wands. Ooh, that was rough. That was rough, Capricorn. If that was you, or the person coming into your life, that was rough. Let me tell you. Ten of Wands, Ten of Swords, it don't get no worse. Yeah, it was time to get the hell out of Dodge. Yeah, Nine of Swords, anxiety. Alright, sleepless nights. I do feel this person had already had you in mind before the breakup even happened. Because you're already in this person's energy. So with a keep an open mind and worth waiting for, there was you guys were definitely in each other's energy for quite some time here. Even if it's just new love. Somehow, some way, you guys cross paths. Whether it's online, through mutual friends, on the street, on vacation, through the workplace, somehow, some way. But this never came to be because they were in something, okay? Or you were in the situation. So take it how it resonates. So they have anxiety. And of course, because they were in that connection that was pretty bumpy, pretty rough, Ten of Swords, Ten of Wands, they're going to have some trust issues and a little anxiety over pursuing this. You know, because they thought, but see, they thought they were with the one, but intuitively, they were thinking about you for a while. I don't know when in the situation you guys met, but they were thinking about you. So they were feeling drawn, and it's because you guys have a deep spiritual connection. So they do want to date you, but they have anxiety. Or you want to date someone. Six of Wands. Okay. This could have been a very open, like a public relationship, you know. Two people thought, you know, victory, yay, victory. Admiration, you know, people admired this couple, but when nobody was around, it was like control issues, arguments, unrequited. I mean, they were showing face for everybody, but they were wearing a mask. Not as happy as it seemed to be. Yeah, the devil. Yep, the old devil. Making it look good when it wasn't. So, you know, maybe they had an open mind. They were like, all right, you know, I find this person attractive. You know, I'm keeping an open mind. You know, there's some red flags, as we saw over there. The devil. Codependencies, addictions, you know, maybe a little too much passion, not enough reciprocity. You know, yeah, sure, let's show off our relationship, you know. And meanwhile, sleepless nights over this. When the devil is involved in a connection, there's something not sitting well with your vibration. And it leaves you with overthinking and anxiety, especially if we're feeling drawn to someone that is not within the connection. Something is off. So this person must have went through some mental turmoil and emotional. Yeah, Seven of Swords. Ouch. Lies and deception. So they get worried that this is going to happen again, of course. For you, Capricorn. We have the Fool. So I feel, you know, it's just time to move on. Time for something new. You know, we've gone through this is the victory after the battle. Victory lap. Okay, so there is a victory lap here. We have made it through the Ten of Wands and the Ten of Swords. And now we're ready for something new. The Fool. Okay. Yep. Closing out a cycle with the devil victoriously here. Most definitely. Saturn is restrictive. So it feels like a fixed energy, right? But it's because there was a major lesson here. And it's slow moving. So, yeah, that was rough. It's okay to keep an open mind. Always remember that the red flags that you choose to ignore in the beginning are usually the ones that end up breaking you up in the end. So there we go. The Empress. The Empress. So this person has anxiety and hoping to God that this is not a deception, that you're the real deal. That's what I'm seeing. Now, they could be sneaking around talking to you for some of you, or you're doing this. Or they're going to come see you, you know, there's something like secretive here. Obviously, this was probably one of their biggest secrets, or yours. Because, you know, you were in another connection, or this person. Page of Wands, message, new beginnings all day, okay, all day. Page of Wands with the Fool, we're treading slowly here, We're getting our creative juices flowing as to how we're going to go about this. Definitely flirtatious energy. Yes, carefree, leaving the rest, the drama behind, and loyal to the path. Hermit mode. Yeah, assessing the situation, going within, looking for answers, and just really honing in on the lesson itself and the knowledge that you gain from it, as well as the insight. So definitely, again, I'm seeing some distance here. Let's see what else. Four of Wands. There you go. With the Divine Feminine, the Empress. Twin flame energy. But somebody's anxious as hell. They're like, this better be real. It is. It's right here. Five of Pentacles. Yeah, I heard pick up the pieces. This person is definitely going to have to pick up the pieces. Like pick themselves back up. Alright, you see the Buddha there that she's talking to. And then we had the snake here. And finally, you know, spiritual growth. Okay. Going within. That's what I'm feeling there. I'm also seeing that the person they were with could have been like super carefree, like, but not in a like free spirited way, like it just careless. It comes from a low place. They could have just been young. I see codependency. Let's see what else here. Nine of Wands. Yeah, this person is pretty much with the Hermit. That's licking his wounds here. Going within. Not wanting to talk to anyone right now. Assessing the situation. This could be you, Capricorn. So take it how it resonates. See what else. Knight of Pentacles. Mm-hmm. It's been a long time coming. For sure. A long time coming. Six of Swords. Lesson learned. Yeah. So, again, Knight of Pentacles with the Five of Pentacles. This person's licking their wounds, assessing the situation. You know, saying what they have to say. Maybe focusing on their creativity. Honing in on, you know, maybe perhaps what they like to do. So that they can, you know, kind of forgive and forget. Keeping themselves occupied. Okay. There will be a message, though, before they come towards you. Of course. And we have the sun. Is this the sun? Yeah. We have the sun. Reflecting back at each other, the best in you with the sun, not the worst in you. So this is nice. And yeah, two people just letting it all hang out. Okay, I see you, you see me. The sun is clarity. Complete clarity. But there is a barrier here between this happiness because someone is, you know, is still going, they're going to probably go through a little bit of healing and assessment, self-assessment, emotional assessment. But, you know, when you have the Six of Swords, with the Knight of Pentacles going towards the sun, you already on that side over there. With your true self, that's you, the Empress. Bam. And they're coming. It's been a long time. But short term is here. And you already saw the Ten of Swords, Ten of Wands. So somebody's single. And they're in hermit mode. So they're taking the time to heal. That's very good. Three of Pentacles, yeah, wanting to collaborate with you, work something out here. All right, build something solid, Four of Wands, absolutely. Judgment, there it is. With the Six of Swords, this is really good. Definitely a lesson learned. They were dealing with karma. Redemption. Redemption, son. For sure, yes. That is really good. Somebody learned their lesson here, Capricorn. So if that's you, yay! Even if it's the other person, both of you. Victory. Victory lap. Victory lap indeed. What is it? Pounce? I don't know. When you know when the horses go like that, you know what I'm saying. Victory lap. Five of Cups. Yeah, this person is, you know, they know the truth. They could be sitting in regret because maybe they didn't follow their intuition before, or you, Capricorn. But, yeah, they need to heal. But they know the truth. There was definitely betrayal with the Ten of Swords and the Ten of Wands. Something very heavy. You know, with unrequited and codependency here. Yeah, control issues, red flags. Freeing yourself from that, yeah. Seven of Pentacles. Yeah, with the world here, that was a whole lesson right there. Okay? It took quite some time. Doesn't have to be 7 years with that specific person. You could have dated somebody or this person, you know, right before this other person. But altogether, there's been 7 years of karma here that somebody was learning. It could be career as well, mixed in with, you know, emotional love type of karma, past life karma. Eight of Pentacles. Yeah. Looking at things from a higher perspective after some time and working on themselves slowly but surely. Six of Pentacles. Yeah, stuck because they were giving it all. Okay? And now they had to establish boundaries. Exactly. Seven of Wands. Not stuck anymore. Stuck in their head, stuck in the situation, stuck in I don't know which way to go. Stuck in, how am I going to make this work? You know, I thought this was going to be a forever connection, and nope, it wasn't meant to be that. All right, so let's get into the scoop deck here, and let's see what else we got for you, Capricorn. One more shuffle. Meant to be. There you go. This relationship is magical and meant to be. Divine Feminine, Four of Wands, Knight of Pentacles, Three of Pentacles. So this is not a lie. Okay. They have clarity. They know this is not a lie. I just feel like they're probably wondering if you have anything going on, whoever the Divine Feminine is here. Okay. Thanksgiving. Something significant about this holiday. So maybe that's when they started to realize, you know what, I'm just not feeling this situation. I don't see myself with this person forever. It was short-lived, or, you know, it was, you know, it had an expiration date. Yeah, seeing through the fog. Your vision is getting clearer with the sun. It's absolutely, there's full clarity here. Now there's just, yeah, kicked out. Someone may be getting kicked out. Ah. I see what happened here. Somebody lied about being the Divine Feminine. If we're just talking about this short-term connection here. Somebody lied about being somebody's twin flame. And that's a karmic soul tie energy. With the Ten of Wands and the Ten of Swords, that was somebody that was here to pretty much either kick your ass or theirs to put them on a ascended path. Okay? There's spiritual growth here. So spiritual growth is not always pretty. And you will encounter soul ties. That's the only way to break you out of repetitive patterns. Right? If everything was cushiony, lovey-dovey, nobody would move forward. They would be stuck in the same situation. for years without going within, healing, or evolving spiritually. So that's what happened here. Somebody lied. They had them fooled, or you, they had you fooled. So take it how it resonates here. So guidance, you're currently being guided. The good thing is that clarity is here, and we know the truth. You know, they were like, if this is my divine feminine, why is this unrequited? Why are there so many red flags? Why do I feel like I need to free myself? The devil was involved. The devil was in the details. That's the lovers right there, the two different paths. And he'll deviate you, making it look like that's the right path when it's a karmic soul tie. The other one is the divine connection. But without this lesson, would we have appreciated the divine, you know, higher vibrational love connection, twin flame, if you will? Would we? Would we have? So they had to go through that, or you, or both of you, you know, however the lesson was meant for you as well. Behind the scenes, there's a lot going on behind the scenes. Things are happening that you can't see. So there's a lot going on here that they are assessing and going through in their mind. They're going back and looking back at certain situations, behavior patterns, you know, with themselves and the other person. Also, what has occurred throughout the connection, what they were forgiving, or what the mask they were wearing that didn't allow them to move forward to and be stuck, the boundaries they weren't setting up at that time. Clearly, you did see the Seven of Wands, so they are establishing those now. Okay, tarot reading. Yeah, someone has gotten a reading done. So they got a reading done and found out that they were not with a divine feminine. It was a lie, and that was the karmic soulmate portraying to be. And the only people that do that would be somewhat narcissistic. Okay, you don't need to portray to be something you're not. So with the Ten of Wands and Ten of Swords and a lot happening behind the scenes with unrequited here, low vibrational shit going on, that's not spiritual growth. That's not somebody that was in it for spiritual growth. They or you had spiritual growth, but the person that they were here with, the short-term connection, that was just a lesson. They were there as karma. So that person wasn't going to learn shit or heal shit. They wanted to take a shortcut and say, oh, I'm the divine feminine. That's not how it works. You don't just say you're a divine feminine or masculine. No, it takes a shit ton of spiritual work and time and effort on each of your parts to get to this level. Seven of Swords with tarot reading, meant to be and kicked out. Yeah, got it. Now, you know, let's see what else before I speak on that. Let's see. Yeah, spell work. Someone has been casting spells. So around Thanksgiving, somebody did something. Okay. And signs and symbols. Watch for the signs from the universe. And I believe they are with the Hermit here and this card. And seeing through the fog and having clarity. And they were confused, exactly. Confusion and conflict may be going on at this time. Something significant about the holidays, something about New Year's. And then we have Muse. You are inspirational to someone. So whether it's the feminine or the masculine here, you are inspirational to somebody here, to this person coming towards you. And their emotions were submerged. Someone's feelings run really deep, but they are concealed. Again, they will grow from the situation. Or you. And they're guarding their heart right now. Very guarded and protective over their heart. Of course, they just went through it. And we have cash flow and manifest. So they could be trying to get their money together again. Or you, Capricorn. We have cash flow with a large lump sum of money. And we have manifest. Your desires are within reach. So there's some, you or this person are manifesting a lot of cash flow right now. The situation there needed more balance, of course, but you can't get balance with someone that you're just learning a karmic lesson from. It doesn't work that way. But of course, you have to know the ins and outs of those types of connections to understand it anyways. That's why they are lessons. Okay, so let's see what's going out outside of the situation. Here, let's see what's happening here. Some of you could be investing in a new car. Putting a down payment. Yeah. You're working to save some money here. Yeah. Because there might be long distance travel here. Yep. To see the lovers. So you might be meeting this person halfway somewhere. So you might have to invest in you're investing in a new car, or you're investing in getting your car in top shape for this road trip for some of you. Or they are. So we have the Queen of Swords, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. Five of Swords. Wow. That's not a good combo. And we already saw the Ice Queen. So this is the Ice Queen. This is the person with the control issues. This is the karmic. Wanting to win at all costs. You know, striking this person down verbally. This is a brutal bitch right here, especially with the devil here. Alright? She cut this person down to size every time. So they're like a little dog with their tail between their legs. They were for some time, but I don't think, you know, I think they finally stood up to this person. Yeah, justice could be Libra here. There's gonna be justice for this. Whatever she did. Yeah, somebody cheated here. Had this person in competition. Yep, Knight of Wands. Wanted to win at all costs. She wanted to create some type of jealousy. I feel like this person really thought she had it like that. It's like, oh, I'm going to cheat on you just to make you want me more. Some people have that mentality. And it's like, are you fucking kidding me? Because she had him feeling so like, I mean, look, Nine of Swords. Riddled with anxiety. Deception. Seven of Swords, Knight of Wands, Ace of Wands, with the Five of Swords. She was trying to make this person jealous. Like, to keep him on a puppet string, wrapped around her finger. Like, this person was pretty cold. Cold-hearted. Yep, there's the lovers. She had another lover. She was trying to make him jealous. Her tactic blew up in her face, basically. Yep. She was trying to create burdens for this person. Ten of Wands again. But they overcame that victory lap. They put that shit down. They said, I don't fucking think so. This is too much for me. Here's your fucking... Everything that I've done for you. All the shit that I've carried on my back for you. All the weight of the world on my shoulders. Here it is. Boom. You can have it. And they did a victory lap. I'm telling you. Yep. King of Pentacles. That's you. Capricorn. Could be another Taurus. Virgo. Or Capricorn here. Capricorn over there as well. Wheel of Fortune. That's the end of that. Lesson learned. Next, please. Thank you. Next. Yeah. Page of Swords. This person knows where they're going. Okay. Five of Cups. That's how the karmic is. Watching. It blew up in her face. But also this person is in pain. But they're single. So this person is healing. Five of Cups over here as well. They regret wasting their time there. But that's what happens when you stay in a situation that you know your intuition is screaming, get out. You know, trying to make a dollar out of 15 cents. Trying to put a square peg into a circle. That's what happens. When somebody's verbally abusive like that, aggressive, controlling, and cheating on you, and at that, it's time to go, man. I mean, obviously, they finally got the picture, but there was red flags. Yeah. It was a self-imposed imprisonment. Yeah, they were trying to manifest their way out of this situation here. Houdini. Okay, drowning in water, trying to get out of the straitjacket that they got themselves in. Houdini went in there all by himself. He thought he could pull it off. He thought he could pull it off, didn't he? It was his demise at the end of the day. Thankfully, this person has another chance to turn their life around. Yeah. There you go. Heartbreak. And they ain't having it. They finally stood up. Now they're using logic where it's needed. This is the kind of situation where you need to use your logic, where you are standing in your truth and you're not questioning at all with the Eight of Swords. But it took heartbreak, it took the truth for them to see it in order for them to be here. So now it's like toe to toe, okay? King and Queen of Swords. With the Five of Swords, this person has been hurt. So now they're going to be cold hearted towards this person because they were cold hearted towards them. That's a done deal. Yeah. They're done giving to that situation and blocked. Access denied. Bottom of the deck, Four of Wands with Temperance and High Priestess. There you go. With the Emperor, there you go. So there's your twin flame. Okay. With the Emperor, High Priestess, spiritual growth. Yes. Anointed. Because they finally got the strength to get out of there. So they're rebuilding their strength and confidence. So have a little patience with them. When they come to you, there's a solid foundation that they want with you, an offer. Okay. Yeah. The person they were with was immature. It was all party, fun and games. A lot of people. She had a lot of people involved. She could have slept with more than one person. She could have slept with his friends. So this person's coming towards you, Chariot with the Queen of Cups. They're gonna say something. Yep, Six of Swords coming towards you after a period of healing. Wow, Capricorn. Some serious drama there. But the lesson has finally been learned. That's a relief. I'm sure it's a relief for this person to finally see it for what it is. So, I did make some cards here with, like, just. I wrote them out myself and I did some like stick figure little drawings on it just to make it fun. So let's see what else we got here. So anything, oops. Let's see. Anything else you want to say here, Spirit, for my Capricorns? Okay, we have Divine Masculine. And I have wanted you for a long time. See? I knew it. So that's what happens when you ignore your intuition and you try to make something else work out for whatever the reason was, you know. Maybe it was too scary, maybe they didn't understand why they felt pulled towards you, but then they had this other situation in hand and, you know, kept ignoring what their intuition was saying till boom, it just blows up in their face. But, you know, let's call it a lesson. Nobody's perfect. It happens. And they've wanted you for a long time. And when they get through this healing, they're coming towards you. Absolutely. They know the truth. I mean, it's clear as day to them. There is no more veil here. And this person cannot pull the veil over their eyes anymore. Yeah, people want to know more about you. They could want to know more about you here. They could be talking to their friends and family about you. Yeah, they were questioning everything. They were. But they know the truth. Yeah, crushing on you too. Yeah. They got you in mind, ready to commit to the things that are within their heart. Anything else, Spirit? Yeah. Be grateful for the blessings to come. They can't keep their eyes off of you. They have complete clarity. It's all or nothing for me. So, it's all or nothing. They know what you want, they know what they want. That's what they always wanted to begin with. Not a cheater, okay? So, they know exactly what they want, Capricorn, or you know exactly what you want and who you're going for, and it's your Divine Feminine. Okay, so, that's what I got for you, Capricorn. Let me know in the comments if anybody resonates. I wish you guys the best, and it's going to take just a little time here, because they need time to heal. But definitely they're coming towards you. They have complete clarity. All right, guys, I'll talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.